Hi everyone, my name is Gil. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the Jewish holiday of Hanukkah, light over darkness. Hanukkah is a Jewish holiday which is celebrated each year relating to something that happened some 2,000 years ago. And there's also a miracle that happened there. The meaning of the word Hanukkah is to dedicate, rededicate. It means to purify. It relates to the story that happened 2,000 years ago in Israel, right there in the Holy Temple. Some 2,000 years ago, the Jewish community was invaded in Jerusalem, in Israel. And the ruling empire was fairly good to begin with, but then suddenly they decided they would not allow the local people to practice their religion. They would not allow it. They came to the temple and they degraded it. Now, there was a small community of Jewish people called the Maccabim who revolted. It took them 3 years, but they finally managed to drive them out. Now, why would I tell you the story? This is one of the earliest known stories about a group who fight for its religious freedom. So I'm not religious. You may not be religious. That's not the point. The point is about religious or cultural freedom. This is one of the earliest stories where people actually fought for it, where people actually said, it doesn't matter, there's only 100 of us against a mighty empire. We're going to fight for our religious freedom. And this is also important for today. Now, I want to tell you a bit about the small miracle that happened there in the Holy Temple in Jerusalem. But before that, I want to tell you about the actual temple. So this Holy Temple, it's the second temple that stood in Jerusalem some 2,000 years ago. And inside, there was something really interesting. You will go into that room, and there was another room. And that central room, that hidden room, is what we call Kodesh Kodashim, which means the holy of the holiest. The most holiest part of Judaism was represented there. A secret chamber. When you would go there, you would see all the glory of the Jewish symbolism. So let me ask you, can you figure out, can you tell me, what would you think you would find in that little chamber, in that little room, the holy of the holiest? Have you got any ideas?
Holy water.
Holy water, okay. Any other ideas?
A relic.
A relic, okay. What else would you find in the holiest room?
Holy book.
Holy books, excellent.
Gold.
Gold, absolutely. So gold, you said holy water, didn't you say? Books, relic, all are things you would expect to find in the holiest room, but the truth is that none of them was there at all. The truth is that the room was completely empty. So you would go to the Jewish holy temple, you would go to the most sacred room, and there was nothing there. It was completely empty. Because in Judaism, we believe that God lives within you. There's nothing from the outside that should influence your belief in God or belief in life. So therefore, you went to the holiest room in the Jewish, you would stood there, and there was nothing. It was empty. You would stood there, and you would feel the silence. We would hear the silence, because God lives within every human being. Before the Kodesh Kodeshim, before that room, there was the menorah. This is a menorah. It is a candle room that holds 8 candles, and that relates to the story of Hanukkah. In the temple, there were 7. There used to be 7. The reason is, when the Maccabim drove out the ruling empire and they went into the temple, it was degraded. And the menorah, the candle broom, was there, but they couldn't find oil to light it up. They used oil, wick and oil. They found only 1 jar of oil, and they said it will light up the menorah for 1 day. But then a miracle happened. They poured the oil inside, and it stood for 8 days. That is the miracle of Hanukkah. 8 days instead of 1 day. Now, why 8? Symbolically, if you take the figure 8 and you tilt it, you light on its side, as you can see here, it represents the symbol of infinity. It represents that the light of life, the light of God, is infinite inside your heart. And for that reason, today we celebrate the holiday using the same menorah, and we light up 8 candles. Now, each day you add 1 candle. So first day of Hanukkah, 1 candle only on the right. Second day, 2 candles. Third day, 3 candles. Until you end up with 8 candles. In the middle, you see the 9th candle right there in the middle. That's called the shamash, the service. This is the candle you would use to light up all other candles. You were not allowed to use the other 8 candles for anything else apart of enjoyment. So if you need to light up anything, you wouldn't use any of the 8 candles. They are just purely for enjoyment. The service, the shamash, is used for lighting up all other candles. Now, the point of celebrating light, Hanukkah, as I said, is light over darkness, is because in Judaism we believe it's better to light a candle than curse the darkness. So that's relevant for today as well, and many cultures are saying this thing. If you see something bad, something evil, so to speak, you have two opportunities, two things that you can do. One, you can stand here and condemn it as much as you want, which is fine. The other thing, you can stand here and you can set up a good example of how to do things properly. That's two ways of approaching life. We can condemn as much as we want. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Or on the other hand, we can set up a good example of good deeds. And if you ask me, what is Judaism in one sentence, I will tell you, that's it. That's all. That's the only thing you need to know about Judaism. It's better to light up a candle than curse the darkness. And in Judaism, we believe that if you take upon Jewish law, Jewish rule, the only thing you need to do is to make sure that you are a good person. That's all. So-called to bring the light into life, bring the light into reality. The interesting thing about light and about candle, you see the little candle, light can be brought only into darkness. You cannot bring light into light. Only where there's darkness, you can put a candle. So in a way, we should never condemn the darkness, because thanks to the darkness, you can put up a light. In Hanukkah, when we light up the candle, we say a little prayer or a little story. At the top, Al Hanisim, that's the Hebrew word which means for the miracle, and Al Haniflaot, for the wonders. So when we light up the candle, we say, thank you, God, thank you, life, for the miracles and for the wonders that happened there and still happening now. Now, for me, this was really confusing. Why do we say, thank you, life, for the miracles that happened? You know, the miracle of driving out the ruling empire, the miracle of oil that should last for one day, lasting for 8 days. So thank you for that miracle. But also thank you for the wonders, Al Haniflaot, for the wonders. And I must say, this is really confusing. What's the difference between miracle and wonders? So let me ask you, what do you think the difference between the word miracle and the word wonders? Any ideas? Different words. Who said that? That's right. Now, words are just symbol to something. So what's the different symbolism? Why do they represent differently? Miracles mean something that happened and it is miraculous. Now, in Judaism, we believe that everything is miraculous. We believe that everything that happens now is a miracle. You are all miracles. People don't realize it, but every single human being is a miracle. If you think of it, the ability to breathe air, transmute air, turns it into energy, that's a miracle. How does this happen? I know there's chemistry, biology behind this, but who governed this rule? Who created this miraculous thing where we can breathe air, transform air into abstract thought? That is a miracle. In Judaism, we think that miracle is not departing the sea into two. You know the biblical story of departing the Red Sea into two, and the Israelites just walk away through that. That's one of the stories. That's not a miracle. That's just playing with nature. But nature in itself is the miracle. We are all miracle. That's the meaning of the word miracle. But wonders, I think, wonders would be when you recognize the miracle. So when you realize how miraculous something is, when you realize how miraculous it is to breathe, to transmute air into pure energy, when you realize that as a human being, then it's wondrous. Then it's become a wonder. So it's the same thing, miracle and wonders. But we thank God for the miracles that happens, and also we thank God for our ability to understand it, our ability to realize things as a human being that can think. So my last slide, I'm going to share with you a little practices that we have in Hanukkah. Top right, what you see is that donuts. We call them sufganiyot. These are donuts baked in oil, because the story of Hanukkah is about the miracle that happened with an oil. So we eat oily food. We also give chocolate corn, as you can see here. And you see the Jewish menorah symbol embedded in that chocolate coin. Why chocolate? Because children love chocolate. Why coins? Because we want to remind children how blessed they are. So remind them to give to charity. It's not just helping other people, also recognizing that we are able to help other people. And the third thing, you see this little toy here? In Hebrew, we call it svivon, from the word to spin, to turn. In Hanukkah, for Hanukkah, there's four letters on it. You see four letters embedded on each, one letter on each face. On the right, Nun, Gimel, Hey, Shin, which stands in Hebrew, Nes Gadol Haya Sham, which means a big miracle happened there. If you are in Israel, it says Nes Gadol Haya Po, a big miracle happened here. It relates again to the story of the ruling empire not allowing the Jewish community to practice Judaism. So they would read the books in hide. When they would see the soldier, they would hide the book and they would pretend to play this svivon, this dreidel. And it has some other symbolism as well. So, two important things to take from our story. One, you go to the Jewish temple, the holiest of the holiest is an empty room because God or life and wonders always live within you. And the second thing to take from this today is better light up a candle than curse the darkness. Thank you very much. Thank you.